I think of Garupe very much as St. Peter, who's like full of doubt and doesn't hide it at all, and is very openly kind of complaining and tired, and which I love. But when he gets tested, he rises to the occasion, where it might be the opposite for Andrew's character, where he starts very committed to, they're both very committed, but their faith is very much challenged in a way where they start putting themselves within this bigger picture than they can't see their role in it anymore, or how useless it is. What was inspiring about it is because he'd been thinking about it for 30 years and kind of planning things that he wanted to do. You know, it could have very easily been a dictatorship where you show up on set and he's like, I've been thinking about this for, you know, 30 years. This is how the movie is going to be. But that it was almost the exact opposite. He certainly did shots that I know, or I've heard that he did shots that he had been thinking about for 30 years. But still, in working with us on it, you got the sense that it was still just as fresh in his mind, and he still kind of approached scenes with like an attitude of he didn't know what the answer would be. And that, for me, was a good lesson, that it's always kind of you hope to see in practice, but to watch someone who's accomplished so much in his career, or been thinking about these characters and knew his material so well, still approach everything with this like youthful curiosity. It's great working with Martin Scorsese, because I grew up watching his movies, and like I think he's the tip of the pyramid as far as like directors alive today. So you kind of go in, you can't help but go in with like a preconceived idea of that, of what it's going to be like. I don't know what that is now in retrospect, ever after having worked with him, but there's so much fear and, you know, reverence, and you can't help but be intimidated by it. But he's very good at, you know, demystifying himself and making it about, you know, focusing on the details. And I think there's some weirdly paternal thing that happens, or maybe the actor-director relationship, where you always just kind of are, you know, actors are very, like, very people-pleasing people, I think, and no more is that more obvious on a set, you know, with a director, you're like, oh my God, like me, tell me what to do, I'll do it, whatever it is you say. And he doesn't want that. He wants you to rebel against him and take ownership of your part. His movies are so good because they're very personal. He puts so much of himself into them, and that's, I think, people are just naturally interested and attracted to people who have a point of view and a voice and a specific specific way of viewing the world. And he's a great collaborator. He gets people together and wants to hear their opinions, and doesn't think that it ends with him. And some kind of a person who approaches things that are new with curiosity as opposed to judgment, I think, is a rare quality to have. It was great working with Andrew because we were starving together, and there was nobody else. Not just because we were starving together. He's a great actor, and he's my age, so I hate him. But one of my favorite moments was we were on a boat, and they had the front of the boat tied to a big rope that they pushed out into the water, and we were shooting this scene where they're pulling us into and onto shore. And when you're losing weight, it's all about timing, you know? Like, you have to time when you, like, have coffee and when you have, you know, a shake, or, you know, so you're, have energy for certain things, especially trying to figure out the rhythm of a set, you know, when is a good time to eat so I'll have energy for this next thing. Anyway, so we're in the middle of this boat, and we're not wearing a lot of clothes, and we're like wrapped in some damp something. It's just me and him, and the entire crew and the rest of the cast and the extras are all kind of on the shore, and they called lunch break when we'd done this a couple times, and so it was just we're like, oh no, that's fine. We don't want to come in. We'll just stay out here in the boat. in retrospect, I think of them Garupe and Rodrigues as heroes. But at the time, I wasn't thinking what they were doing was heroic, I guess, necessarily. They just made a commitment and they were doing that. I don't think people who are heroic think of themselves as being heroic. They're just standing up for what they believe in. But in retrospect or on the outside, if I heard of that person today, that going to those great lengths to, to follow through with what you believe in for the sake of other people is a heroic act.